Very good morning, class. Yesterday we have done our relative velocity in one dimension and two dimension, and I explained you how to solve the numerical based on the relative velocity. So as the chapter name is motion in plane, you know, plane means plane is a consist of two dimension, either x axis, y axis, or y z or z x, right? Two dimension. And if the body moves such that either of two dimensions will change, x, y, y, z, z, x. So if change occur in both the dimensions simultaneously, then we can say the body is moving in a plane. Right? For example, if a body is moving in a circular path, right? So when the body is moving in a circular path, you can see here that body covering the x distance also and the y distance also. That means body is performing the motion in plane. We will discuss circular motion in the chapter after the laws of motion, but here we have one more very important motion in plane, which is known as projectile motion. Now, what is projectile motion? Let's understand this first. The topic is projectile motion. Now, what does projectile means? It's quite simple. The body performing the projectile motion is known as projectile. Right now, how can a body be considered as projectile? To understand this, let's see. Suppose we have a ball, right? And it is moving in a straight line. Suppose it's moving in a straight line with velocity u. Now, a force started acting parallel to the direction of the motion. What will happen? That means the force is acting in the same direction where the body is moving. So, due to this, the body will start increasing its velocity. Why? Obviously because force is acting in the same direction. So when force or acceleration acts in the same direction to the velocity, then only the magnitude of velocity changes. Suppose it is moving with, let's say, 5 meter per second, then after some time the velocity will become 10 meter per second, 20 meter per second, and so on. But is the direction of the body is also changing? No. Why? Because the acceleration which is acting on the body is in the same direction as velocity. But what happened if body is moving in this direction, but I start pushing the ball downwards? And what will happen? Body will not move like this. Instead of this, body will start moving like this. And if I act force upward direction, then what will happen? The body will start moving like this. That means if the acceleration on the body acts different on the different line to the velocity, then body will change its direction. And same thing happened with the projectile motion also. So let us understand what is a projectile motion, and then we will discuss about the important points regarding the projectile motion. In the case of projectile motion, when the body moves in a direction other than vertical, that means making an angle theta with the horizontal like this. Suppose this is the ground and this is the vertical plane. If a body starts moving at certain angle with the horizontal other than 90 degrees, because if it is moving like this, that means the motion will be vertical motion, it will be not be considered as projectile motion. Then at every point, if you see at every point, gravity acts normal to the motion of the body. suppose you kick a ball, you kick a football, then obviously ball will take a path like this. And if you see, at every point, the gravity is acting vertically downwards. And that's why the ball or the such kind of body will take a curved path. That curved path is known as trajectory. Right? So when a body moves at a certain angle with the horizontal, and gravity acts on it at a vertically downwards, then such kind of motion of body is known as projectile motion. Now the main thing is that we have only the acceleration, because you know that gravity is a kind of acceleration, right? So we have acceleration only in downward case, not in the horizontal case, not in the we can say horizontal plane. We have the gravity, we have the acceleration only in the vertical plane. And due to this, the path of the body changes continuously. Right? So let's see what are the basic examples of the projectile motion. There are many examples, like I have given an example that this is the horizontal plane and this is a football. You kick a football, so football will go like this. So football can be considered as a projectile, and the motion of projectile, this football will be considered as the projectile motion. Okay, suppose a fighter plane is going and it drops a bomb, right? So when this is the fighter plane, right? This is the fighter plane, it's going and it drops the bomb. So what would be the path of bomb? It will not fall like this, because the plane is moving. The bomb will fall like this. Again, this is also the type of projectile motion. Suppose you fire a bullet, right? You have a gun. This is the gun. Now you fire a bullet. Now when you fire a bullet, that bullet will also take the same path like this, a projectile motion. We thought that bullet is moving in the same straight line, but it's not. Because as the bullet comes out from the nozzle, gravity acts on the bullet in the downward direction, which tend to change the direction of the bullet. So bullet will not change, will not move in the straight line, but it will move in a curved path. There's a very famous question in the projectile motion. Let me ask you that. The question is, a monkey is sitting on the tree. Alright, suppose this is a tree and a monkey is sitting here. This looks like a bird, but it's not bird, it's a monkey. I'm not a very good artist. Okay, now you aim, you are here on the same ground, and you aim this monkey with a toy gun, right? Obviously, you don't have to kill the monkey, you're just using a toy gun, because he is stealing some fruits from this your tree. So as the bullet comes off from the nose, at the same time monkey jumps from the tree in vertical direction like this. Now tell me, is the bullet hit the monkey or not? Because as this time the bullet comes out of the nozzle, and from the voice, this monkey jumped from the tree. Some people think that bullet will not strike the monkey because we have aimed to this point, but now the monkey is coming down. But you know that the monkey is acted by gravity, which is in downward direction, which has the magnitude of 9.8 meter per second. Also, this bullet have also acted by gravity, whose value is 9.8 meter per second square. So the actual path of bullet will not like this, but it will go like this, and here the bullet will strike the monkey. So it's a possibility that bullet will not strike the monkey if monkey will not change its position, right? So everything which is moving under the gravity, they are not moving a straight line, right? They will take a curved path, and this is known as projectile motion. Let me discuss some very important point regarding the projectile motion. See, this as the projectile motion is the example of motion in plane. That means body moves simultaneously in both the dimension x and y, or either in two dimension, obviously x, y, by the or zx. When body moves, suppose this is the x direction and this is the y direction, and body initial velocity of the body is like this is u. So we can resolve this initial velocity into two components. If the angle is theta, first the velocity in the horizontal direction, that is ux, and second in the vertical direction, that is uy. Okay, so horizontal velocity, will be ux, and that can be equals to u cos theta. You know that we have done this part in the vectors also. Second, in the y direction, will be known as vertical velocity. Uy, u sin theta. Now, you know that gravity acts in a vertical plane. That means gravity will only affect the vertical component of the velocity. And due to that, this component, the vertical component of velocity, is continuously changing throughout the motion. It will not remain constant. Right? Why? Because we know that A is nothing but del v by del t. So if acceleration is acting on the body in a certain direction, then obviously there will be change in velocity also. And you know that when body moves like this, the gravity always acts in a vertical plane. So the vertical velocity component is always changes continuously. It is a variable, it is a non-uniform velocity. But if you consider the horizontal velocity ux, then you see here that there is no force acting in the horizontal direction. There is no acceleration. And if obviously if A is zero, then V will be constant. So the horizontal velocity is constant throughout the motion. It will not change, and it's a uniform component of velocity. Alright, one more point, that vertical velocity component and horizontal velocity component are independent to each other, right? So it means if I say that at the initial point the horizontal velocity is let's say 5 meters per second and uy was let's say 10 meters per second, and after some time uy changes, let's say uy becomes 10 to 5, what would the change in ux? So ux will not change, it will remain constant throughout the motion, because we generally ideally we think that there is no acceleration acting in the horizontal direction, right? But if we talk about the practical thing, practically it's not possible, because air drags act in the horizontal direction as well. Okay, so but here ideally we are saying that there is no sign of force or the acceleration in x direction. So these are three important points. First, the horizontal velocity is ux cos theta, and the vertical is uy equals to u sin theta. Second point, that the vertical velocity component changes continuously throughout the motion due to gravity, and gravity always acts vertically downward on the body. Second point, that horizontal velocity component is constant throughout the motion because there is no force acting in the horizontal direction. And the last point, that vertical velocity component and the horizontal velocity component, they both are independent to each other. There will be no relation between them, right? It's not like that if ui is changing, ux has to be changed. No, they will be independent to each other. There is some assumption that we made when we study the projectile motion for the ease of calculation. Like first, we think that we ignore the curvature of the earth, because obviously earth is not flat. Earth is not like this. Earth is curved like this. And obviously if you throw any body on the horizontal surface or on the inclined plane, the motion will be a bit different. But due to very large radius of the earth, we consider that earth is not curved, but it's a flat. Second thing, we neglect the effect of rotation of the earth, right? Due to rotation of the earth, there are some effects that affect the motion of the body, like Coriolis effect and all. So we are not interested in that, because there is a very, we can say, minimum effect occur due to that forces, right? So we are assuming that the earth is not rotating, but it is stationary. We are neglecting the effect of rotation of the earth. Then a very important effect, although we can say it has to be considered, right? But we are not considering, and that is the air drag, the air friction, because obviously if you throw anything from some height, then air drags act opposite to the motion, right? Gravity is acting downward, but air drag acts opposite to the motion. So but here we are again neglecting the air drag, right? In any equation we are not considered the air drag. Yeah, if in any equation it is mentioned that you have to take the air drag, that's a different thing, but usually we will consider that there is no friction in air, so there will be no effect on the motion of the body due to air drag, right? So these are some, we can say, assumption that we take when we solve the projectile motion. Now, projectile motion can be of three types: oblique projectile motion. It's a most simple projectile motion like this, like you are kicking a football plate on the ground. Second, we have horizontal projectile motion. It's like I'll give you an example, that fighter plane drop a bomb, right? So that means the body, it drop at some height. And the third is inclined projectile motion. That means you have already at a certain angle, like you are standing on a mountain, right? And then you kick a ball with angle theta. This is called inclined projectile motion, but in our syllabus we only have the oblique projectile motion and the horizontal projectile motion. So tomorrow I will derive some important formulas and equation for the oblique projectile motion and the horizontal projectile motion. So please don't miss out the lecture. Till then, thank you so much, class.